After a long and very successful run of Eugene O'Neill's Long Day's Journey into Night, the young director David Wellington persuaded Hutt to transform his performance of the self-destructive James Tyrone for the big screen.
The big difference between Bill Hutt and James Tyrone, and the kind of remarkable contrast between the man and the role he's playing in the movie, is that the man has built his life exactly how he wants it, totally, utterly, completely, uncompromisingly. James Tyrone is a character who has built his life absolutely spent his whole life building a model blindly in the pursuit of money, and has built his life exactly how he doesn't want it. And you can't have a more profound contrast, I think, between an actor and a character that the actor's playing.
1874. When Edwin Booth came to the theater in Chicago where I was leading man, I played Brutus to his Cassius one night, Cassius to his Brutus the next, Othello to his Iago, and so on. Well, the first night I played Othello, he said to the manager, "That young man is playing Othello better than I ever did." That from Booth, the greatest actor of his day, or any other. And it was true.
One of my earlier definitions of acting, and when I began to think about just what is involved in acting, and I came to the catchphrase, which suits me: acting is the art of being private in public, so that the audience watching this process should perhaps feel just slightly guilty that they're looking through the window at something they shouldn't be seeing. I think it's that intimate.
Michael Caine is playing this despicable character, Pierre Boursard, who was responsible for the murder of 7 Jews in a village during World War II. Bill Hutt plays the Monsignor Lemoyne, who, in a way, has always protected Boursard.
I have to confess.
What's happened?
I've killed a man.
Who?
A Jew.
How did you know it was a Jew?
Well, I have proof. It's a statement that says that for the offense in Dombey, they mean to execute me for Dombey.
If, as you say, you have proof, make it public. The people will see that the Jews are persecuting you. This may be the perfect moment for you to come forward.
He starred in the film version of Timothy Finley's novel, The Wars, with Martha Henry and Brent Carver. In this scene, where he plays a father to a departing son, you can feel the resonance of personal history.
I do remember that moment. I was saying goodbye to my son as he goes off to war, because I remember so distinctly my father writing this extraordinary letter saying goodbye to both his sons. So there was, I mean, that the minute was filled with my own experience.
Film and television have never held Hutt's attention for long. As if succumbing to the pull of gravity, he always ends up back home, live bodies, speaking and breathing in a large room. The theater. It's getting very near the end now. an 85-year-old actor, 6 months into The Tempest, and only a few performances left. It's been an almost unimaginable career for William Hutt.
I am aware of age, when the limbs don't work quite as agilely as they did 15 years ago, which in fact they don't. I don't feel that old. In my mind, I'm young. The day before yesterday, I had a portrait session with a photographer inside the Festival Theater at a spot where what I was looking at was a series of pictures. And I looked around and I began to be very wistful about the number of people that I was looking at and had been friends with, acted with, were no longer with us. Lorne Greene, Nicky Pennell, Butch Blake, Tony Van Bridge, Alan Bates, all gone. I grew old with them. Since I'm still here, perhaps there's a tiny, tiny, tiny moment when I feel lonely. Left behind. I have been in theater for 57 years now, 55, the greatest percentage of which I have spent in the world of Shakespeare. And what an extraordinary world to be involved in for all that time. And the opportunity in some instances to do the same thing yet another time, yet another time, yet another time. And as each time comes up, your life experience is broader and you can bring more to it and you understand more about the playwright. I am 85. It's time I retired, certainly from the stage. Feeling that it's time I retired, it can so easily inform what I'm saying, what I'm doing in The Tempest.
I want spirits to enforce, art to enchant, and my ending is despair, unless I be relieved by prayer, which pierces so that it assaults mercy itself and frees all faults, as you from crimes would pardoned be. Let your indulgence set me free.